Solve the equation. Negative 1/2 x plus 2/3 equals 6. You can use a visual model to solve this, but it's a little cumbersome because you have uncommon denominators. I'm going to focus on the algebra process here, which is just working with the actual numbers and variable. So because we have fractions with an uncommon denominator, there are really two different ways to solve here, and I'll show you both methods. Then you can decide which method you prefer best. So my first method is to work with the fractions. I'm going to subtract the 2/3 from both sides. And that's going to leave negative 1/2 x. And plus 2/3 minus 2/3 equals 0. So then we just have the negative 1/2 x on the left equals 6 minus 2/3. To combine, we need a common denominator. So I'm going to take the 6 and multiply by 3 over 3. And that equals 18 over 3. So then my negative 1/2 x equals 18 over 3 minus 2 over 3. Negative 1/2 x equals 16 over 3. And then to solve for x, I need to multiply by the reciprocal of negative 1/2, which is negative 2. So it'll be negative 2 over 1 times negative 1/2 x equals negative 2 over 1 times 16 over 3. So negative 2 over 1 times negative 1/2 equals 1, because we have, I'll do the work up here. Negative 2 over 1 times negative 1 over 2. If you multiply negative 2 times negative 1, it makes positive 2, and then 1 times 2 is 2, so 2 over 2 reduces to 1. So we have 1x, which can be written as x equals negative 2 times positive 16, multiplying straight across here, is negative 32. And then 1 times 3 is 3, so divided by 3. You could leave your answer in this form, or you can do the division to make it a mixed number. So let's do 32. How many times does 3 go into it? I have a 1. 1 times 3 is 3. 0, bring down the 2. And then 3 does not go into 2, so put a 0. 0 times 3 is 0. Subtract, and I get 2. So we have 10 with a remainder of 2, which is 10 and 2/3. Now remember, this was a negative 32, so x equals negative 10 and 2/3. Okay, so there's your exact answer. Now, as another way to solve this, you can multiply the whole equation through by the least common multiple of 2 and 3. And that would be 6, because 2 times 3 equals 6. So let me show you what that looks like. 6 times negative 1/2 x plus 2/3 equals 6 times 6. So now I'm going to distribute the 6 on the left, and that looks like this. It'll be 6 times negative 1/2 x plus 6 times 2/3 equals 6 times 6, which is 36. Now I'm going to simplify this. 6 over 1, 6 over 1, and multiply. 6 times negative 1 is negative 6, and then 1 times 2 is 2, and then so it's negative 6 over 2, and then times this x right here, plus 6 times 2, which is 12, and then divided by 1 times 3, which is 3, equals 36. Then I'm going to simplify each of these fractions. Negative 6 divided by 2 is negative 3, so we're going to have negative 3x plus 12 divided by 3, which is 4, equals 36. Okay, so this was a lot of work, but now you have an equation with no more fractions in it. It's easier to solve than maybe the one on the right that we just did. Okay, now I can subtract 4 from both sides. So I get negative 3x equals 36 minus 4, which is 32. Then to finish solving, divide both sides by negative 3. And I get x equals negative 32/3, which is the same as the answer with the other method also. And that also means x equals negative 10 and 2/3 if you were to divide this out. So here I showed you two different methods to solve an equation that has various rational numbers, fractions, and integers in it. You can either work with the fractions and solve the problem, Or you can multiply through by the least common multiple and then solve from there. And you can use whichever method you like best.